Welcome to our video course about QuickBooks Online. In this video, we'll learn how to set up bank feeds for QuickBooks Online. To set up bank feeds in QuickBooks Online, you barely have to do anything. All you have to do is click Banking from the left panel, type in the name of your bank if it's not already there on the list, double-click to choose it, put in your username and password, and then it will ask you to match the accounts that are online to the in your QuickBooks Online account to the accounts that are in your online banking. That's all you have to do, and it barely takes a minute. Watch. Here we are at the test video company here in the QuickBooks Online account. So again, from the left panel, click Banking. And if you first created your company, you'll see a list of financial institutions that you can double click on. If yours is not here, you can type it into the search bar. It just so happens that I will be using Chase Bank and PayPal as the example financial institutions to set up the bank feeds. I'm going to start with Chase. I'm going to double click, and then all the computer is asking me for is my Chase ID, which is CompuTapes, and then the password that I had set up before. Click the button to prove you're not a robot. And then, of course, you know, images with road. I guess, you know, you have to go past your bank security features. This has a road, this has a road, this has a road. I guess that counts as a road. So you got to click past these features and click verify. Please also check the new images. Okay, now we have to do it again. Here's a road. Here's a road. I guess that's a road. You know, you just have to click past your bank security features, click verify. Street signs, boy, they really, really want you to be sure. Okay, wow, they really, really want to make sure that it's you and not a robot. So now that we got past that, boy, Chase has some very tough security. We log into Chase through our QuickBooks Online. Your bank might have different security features that you have to get through. In fact, they're even going to text me. Boy, they never really stop with the security features. And I guess we click. We come here. And of course, they have text me my temporary identification code. Let me take a look. And after typing in the code, we click, and we finally made it past all the crazy security that Chase makes us do. And now we get to match the accounts that are in your online banking to the accounts that are in your QuickBooks Online. Premium plus checking is going to be Chase Personal, and business checking will be Chase Business. And I think that's it for Chase, and I'll click Connect. Now, after we click Connect, it should only take a few seconds, really, for all of the transactions going as far back as Chase will allow to be downloaded in to my QuickBooks Online account. Now it allows you to click this green button to review the transactions that have come in. Now, I suggest you do not click Let's Do It. I suggest you click this little text here, I'm a pro, skip this. If you click Let's Do It, you have to go through everything one at a time, and you can only see it one transaction at a time on your screen. But if you click I'm a pro, let's skip this, here you get right to the review list, and this is the list that you'll be working with. Where it says Chase Personal, these are all the transactions that have downloaded. Actually, yeah, all the transactions that have downloaded in the Chase Personal account. If you click here and you flip it to Chase Business, then then all of the transactions that downloaded from the business bank account will show up here. Now it's very easy to navigate this review list, but remember, these transactions are not yet in your QuickBooks records. You have to review them and then decide if you want to add, match, or exclude them. Add means you record it into your QuickBooks records and it actually affects your financial reports. Match means you're going to tell QuickBooks that this transaction has already been entered into QuickBooks manually, and it will therefore exclude it from the review list and from QuickBooks. Or you can click exclude. Now remember, clicking match and clicking exclude do the same thing. All that happens is that it gets removed from the review list. But if you click exclude, it puts it on a separate list, a list of items that were excluded. And that list will be permanent until you delete the items from the exclude list. So look, if we come here, we scroll up and down. So how do you make those choices for each of these transactions? Well, just click anywhere in the line. So we're doing this bank account and we're reviewing each of these transactions. Click anywhere in the line and then the blue bar will open up under the transaction. That's where you have a choice of adding it, matching it to an existing transaction. Okay. If you click match, you would get a list of available matches here that you could match it to. And that video is coming soon and we'll talk all about matching and unmatching transactions. If you choose to match, if you choose find a match, if you click transfer, it assumes that you're transferring the money to another bank or equity type of account, which does happen. So these are your three choices, and they're based on the text in this description field that comes from the bank. And if you don't want to work with this transaction, you click the X to close it out, and you can pick another one. Click here. The blue bar opens under the transaction where you have a choice to add it, find a match, which again, the available possible matches would show up here, and we'll talk about that in a future video, or transfer it to another bank account or bank or equity type of account. You can scroll all the way up and down to see all of the transactions that have been downloaded, and you have to go through these one by one. Remember, just because the bank recorded them, it doesn't mean it's correct.